Cooper Webb, and I choose OGIO.
I'm Christian Craig.
I'm Dean Wilson.
I'm Aaron Plessinger.
I'm Jerry Martin.
I'm Nate Thrasher.
I'm Shane McElrath.
I'm Hunter Lawrence.
My name's Jet Lawrence.
I'm Jordan Smith.
I'm Tal Hawkins.
Stargate Hampshire.
I'm Hayden Deegan.
I'm Colt Nichols.
And I choose OGIO.
And I choose OGIO.
And I choose OGIO.
I'm Tom Diala. I choose OGIO.
And I choose OGIO.
And I choose OGIO.
I'm Jiren Ferrangis.
And I choose OGIO.
Hey everyone, welcome to the SML Show presented by OGIO Powersports and Yamaha Motors. I'm joined today by Monster Energy Kawasaki, Pro Circuits, Levi Kitchen. So, Chef.
Yeah.
Welcome back, dude. You got some new hat and new shirt on today.
Yeah. Well.
Oh, so, no, you're a Monster before. Yeah, what am I thinking?
Same stuff, but we're on a different bike now.
Yeah.
So,
what, so you got like 2 months?
On the bike?
Yeah. Because I know
I've got about a month.
A month? One of your first days was at Kauai, right? Because of Scrub Dead, he sent me pictures of you.
Yeah, so that actually, I finished SMX, and then I came here, rode for 2 days because it was, LA is closer to Hawaii. So I just stayed here, and then I went straight to Hawaii for vacation.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I rode a couple days outdoors. Scrub Daddy seen me out there, yeah.
No hiding from him.
No, and then went on vacation for... Yeah, I took about a month off.
Oh, yeah? You didn't stay in Hawaii for a month, did you?
No. I went for
it's
a week.
It's expensive.
Went for a week there and then just kind of cruised around, went back to Florida, got my new house all dialed in. So.
Did you just buy a new house in Florida?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Yep.
Is that like a real recent thing or?
Yeah, pretty. Well, I had a house up in Tallahassee, but now I'm further south, so down by Claremont, that area. So
yeah.
Bought a house there.
Dude. Florida weather and everything is such, it's like the polar opposite of where you're from.
I know.
Pacific Northwest. I mean, I think the moisture levels are probably about the same, but the humidity's off the hook.
Yeah, the humidity there is ridiculous, but like supercross time in Florida is sick.
Yeah.
I mean, and outdoors is, it's good for you. By no means is it really like the nicest thing, but it's good training because it's so hot. So,
am I correct? You won the last moto of your season.
Yeah, technically. Yeah.
I had heard that, like, or was there any, like, should I win this race? Should I not? Because I heard there was, like, some, you know, team, work for the team.
I mean, there wasn't much talked about. There was for sure, coming in, obviously, I think Hayden was, like, I'm forgetting. I don't know if he was first in points or second. It might have been second.
Second, but Jet was out.
Something like that, yeah.
Hunter
so they were kind of talking about him, like, you know, he had a good shot at winning it. And then Brad actually, Hoffman, he realized, he's like, well, you're, it's almost like I kind of forgot, but I was pretty close too, actually. I mean, I was in fourth, like, something crazy could have happened. I could have won it.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, there wasn't much, like, team orders or nothing. And then, obviously, once they see me get 10th the first moto, like, yeah, and I was leading the second one. I mean, there was no thought in my mind. I was like, I'm just going to win this, I guess. And
yeah, did that feel pretty good to go out with a bang?
Yeah, it did, for sure. It was actually probably the most frustrating win I've ever had, though, like moto win, to be honest. Just because it just got so old, like... I don't even know how many times I've done that where I'm like nowhere to be found. And then I do that. So I got, it felt good, but at the same time, it didn't even mean anything to me, to be honest.
What did you end up overall in SMX?
Fourth.
Fourth.
Yeah.
How much did you make from that?
Just over 100.
Just over 100.
Yeah.
So remember the beginning of the season, they had the press conference.
Yeah.
And it was like everyone was pretty much in the dark about it,
yeah.
Even the riders,
yeah.
The journalists. I'm like, well, what, how does the points work mm-hmm. and everything. But like, I'm sure for you guys, you're probably kind of like three more races at the end of yeah. the year, shorter off season, a little over 100 grand is worth it though, right?
For sure. I mean, once it was all said and done, like, yeah, I actually just got that pretty recently. And like, yeah, I can't complain. Having that go in the bank account is obviously nice. You know, obviously next year I want it to be even more than that. But no, once it's all said and done, it's definitely worth it for sure. But it was just so weird coming into it because, like you said, it was like nobody knew. Like at first it was like, we're thinking like, just the way they worded it all, I'm like, man, you could make $1 million off this thing. Or yeah. like, I didn't know if it was 100,000 a weekend or what, like, it was just all over the place. And then it still ended up being great. Like, I think yeah. it's good for us. As far as the tracks go, they were pretty good. I can't remember, was it Chicago? Was a little bit weird, like with it being kind of outdoors, it was a little fast, mm-hmm. but the other two were pretty good.
Yeah, I feel like LA was just straight up supercross.
Pretty much.
But like, yeah. you know, the whole blending of supercross, yeah. motocross.
I feel like, honestly, at that point, they should have, like, what bummed me out is with LA being that supercross related, mm-hmm. I wanted a set of whoops, you know, to separate more. So, because even like if you go watch, I mean, I'd have to get like hats off to probably Smitty on set. Like, he was really the only one you saw go through the pack in that first moto. Mm-hmm. Because other than that, everybody was the same speed. I mean, yeah. it was, we were all just matching each other because there was really nowhere to separate.
Yeah. How fired up was he after the second moto? He got punked.
Oh, I know. Yeah, he came back to the semi. He was definitely bummed. But I think he was still stoked just because he got that first one.
Yeah, for sure. You've closed out your career with Star where you started. I remember being at Fox Raceway when you were in your moose gear and you were mm-hmm. testing Loki and they're like, don't say anything.
Yeah.
But you had a good run with the team, I think.
Yeah,
did you have a good
for
time
sure.
there?
Yeah, I mean, everything was awesome there. And what, two years pro with them. We accomplished quite a bit for sure. Like, mm-hmm. yeah, there was a lot of good moments with them. But yeah, I mean, my contract was up obviously, and now we're here with Pro Circuit.
Yeah. So you're here with Pro Circuit with three teammates?
Four.
Yeah. Okay. But as opposed to like 23 teammates, what was it like at the farm? Was it hectic? And then what chaos did the Deegan world bring to the facility?
It didn't, like, at the facility there was no it wasn't even any different. Like, it was pretty good. We had a pretty good group. Obviously there's quite a few of us, but you know, you had somebody hurt one time, so it never really felt like a ton of people. But at the races he definitely brings in a lot of people, and it's kind of wild. Like, the weirdest thing was how many people I think he brings in that aren't not super familiar with the sport, I would say. Mm-hmm. Like, my favorite part was just how people would come up to me and, like, I'd get called, like, people would be like, oh, can I get your autograph, Nate? Like, talking about Thrasher, or, like, me and Smitty were standing there one day in the autograph line, and I forget even what they called him. Like, it was like a whole nother person, a whole different team. Like, mm-hmm. can I get your autograph? And it's like, wow, you really don't know anything about the sport. But yeah, it was pretty hectic.
Yeah. Was it all pretty fair amongst all the 250 guys, or was there like more attention paid to the guys who were winning?
No, it was pretty fair. Yeah. I mean, for sure, I think it's hard for any team, like, no matter where you go, like, all eyes are going to be on the one winning. I mean, it's just the way it goes. Like, but as far as, you know, equipment and that kind of stuff, yeah, I mean, mm-hmm. they're not gonna short you.
Do you guys get along okay?
Who?
You and Hayden, or the whole team, I mean.
Oh, yeah, like. Yeah. No, we all got along great. There was never any blowouts or anything yeah. crazy.
So the big switch, was it a personal choice? You want, felt like it was time for some change, or did you get a better offer? No offer to stay, or what ultimately led you to switch teams?
I had an offer to stay, and truthfully, I was we were working on that, but I just wanted to kind of get away and do my own thing, and that was the big reason. Like, after they said I couldn't go do some stuff on my own, then that was when I started, you know, exploring my other options. Like, I gave them, you know, first choice, obviously. Mm-hmm. But yeah, you know, they want to have everybody together, which is fine. That's the way they do it. So I ended up, you know, talking to some other teams and ended up with Mitch, and it's been great. You know, he's super, I don't know, he's kind of willing to try anything, which is cool. Mm-hmm. And that was the big part for me. Like, I'm out here for a little bit getting the bike dialed, and then I fly back to Florida, get to work, me, Chase, and Tom, and Ken will be out there also. Mm-hmm. A couple other guys even too. So, yeah, just him giving me that chance to, I think it's more of a trust thing. You know, he trusts me, which is good. And obviously, I got to get the results, which I believe I will. So, yeah, I'm super thankful for that.
Yeah, when you said you want to do some stuff on your own, is that what you're alluding to? You wanted to train somewhere else? And
Yeah. I just wanted to just work on some stuff, like, by myself, and kind of just focus on myself more. And it's hard when, you know, your main competition, because with any of those guys, Hayden, Nate, Jordan, like, they're all riding really well, and, you know, you're all doing the same thing. So mentally, I think for me, this will be helpful, just because I don't, it's just kind of me now, obviously, and Chase, Tom, whatever, in the gym and stuff, but I know how much I'm putting in, and it's just going to give me more confidence, I think, going to these races. So.
Cool. We're going to take a quick break to hear from our sponsors. We'll be back for more. Everyone, welcome back to the SML Show presented by OGIO Powersports and Yamaha Motors, here with Levi Kitchen. So it's got to be exciting. Like, I know, like, through my career, I've only changed jobs 3 times, but every time it's kind of scary because you don't know where you're going. But then when you finally give your notice and make the decision, it's super exciting from that point on. And a little nervous going to the new place and getting a feel for the surroundings and everything, but it's got to work that way for team change too, right?
Oh, for sure. There's a lot of, you know, there's so many nights that you're like, did you make the right decision? You know what I mean? I mean, mm-hmm. I think it happens to everybody, I'm sure. But then as things start going along, like, you know, right, like, as of now, I've been riding, training, like, I'm so happy with everything. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I mean, but that's everything in life. I mean, I feel like you got to kind of take some risks. So, yeah, it was definitely a little bit weird at first, but after all said and done, I'm really stoked on the decision I made. Mm-hmm.
How does it affect your current team dynamic when you have to tell them I'm going elsewhere? Like, how many races were left in 2023 when Bobby and everyone knew that you were leaving?
They pretty much knew before outdoors.
Oh, so the whole series.
Yeah. I mean, well, they knew that something was going to happen. You know what I mean? Like, pretty much the end of Supercross is when things start getting talked about, and even with other people it can be earlier than that. Mm-hmm. But for me, that's about when it was. And yeah, it's a tough position for both sides. Like, you know, you don't feel like if you don't, it's hard to, you always feel like maybe once you leave, like you're like scared if they're gonna still support you as much as they did or whatnot. But yeah, they were good about, you know, like we still, I mean, did pretty well in outdoors and stuff like that. So I don't know, that was definitely a weird a weird part at first, but and a little bit emotional, like at the end, you know. Mm-hmm. You're leaving somewhere, it's just like leaving a job. But and there was absolutely no hard feelings either way. It was just I couldn't get what I asked for. So
yeah. Okay, so you're off of you know, the bike that's regarded as the horsepower monster, right? Mm-hmm. And now you're on another bike that's got a lot of championships, but the Pro Circuit team, I think their last title was Justin Hill several years ago. So I have to imagine Mitch is really hungry, and that's probably part of the reason he's allowing you to do stuff, because whatever's going to work, you're probably the guy with the most promise. But what's the new bike like compared to, you know, the all-conquering YZ250F?
Yeah, I'm sure it's a lot of people are wondering, but they're both Japanese bikes, so they're, to me, they feel pretty similar. But you know, Star's obviously known for the horsepower, and you know, their bike is fast for sure. But the Kawasaki's great, like handling wise, it turns really, really well. Mm-hmm. It's a really narrow feeling bike, so easy to kind of flick around and stuff. But I don't know why. Like, I've even had several people come up to me and talk to, like, that have seen me ride now. I feel like I fit the bike a little bit better, and I'm not quite sure where on the bike it makes me feel that way, but yeah, something about it just like it really clicked. I mean, there's no, like, I've been riding for a month and I already feel just fine. Like, I feel like I could go racing right now and do well. So but yeah, I mean, every bike has its pros and cons. Mm-hmm. For sure.
How long does it take a guy at your level, pro guy, to get to that point where you can hang it out past, you know, the level of control and how far you could go? Like, how long did it take you to get fully comfortable
on this bike? A couple weeks. I mean, just these last few weeks, like, I've been on the bike for a little while, but like, you know, I haven't rode, I'd say, a ton of times yet. Mm-hmm. But yeah, a few weeks now, and like these last few days especially, I've been, you know, like right now I'm just putting in my laps. I'm not really too worried about my speed because we mm-hmm. still have a lot of time. So every once in a while though, I'll go throw down, like, just to reassure myself that I can go really fast on mm-hmm. this bike. So yeah, I'm already comfortable going that speed on it.
At this point in the game, is there anything that you're riding the new bike and going, oh, this is easier or better?
Cornering, like,
really?
Yeah. Yeah, the cornering is unreal on this thing. Like, I'm not sure how, obviously the new Yamaha, that's completely different, but compared to the one I was on, yeah, this one turns really well. It's a really balanced bike. I was afraid it might lose a little in the whoops. The Yamaha is really good in the whoops. Mm-hmm. But this bike's phenomenal in the whoops also. So I don't know if that's just the aluminum frame or what it is, but yeah, it does everything really well.
Are you bringing the steak pigs with you?
Oh, I don't even know. I think Mitch brought that up, actually. And, oh, yeah, I'm going to test them for sure.
Oh, yeah, that's an outdoor thing for you, though. Yeah. Not soupy.
I don't know if I'll need them with this bike, though. Like, the Yamaha was wide up front, kind of got narrow. So, mm-hmm. like, you felt like you would kind of fall back into that spot. This thing's pretty skinny where, like, I don't know, it's easy to grip. So, I'm not too sure. I mean, I'll probably try them. But
mm-hmm. It's so funny because... Remember when you started running them? I'm like, dude, really? And you're like, go get some. They're good. Because they sent them to me like 10 years ago at Transworld. Yeah. And I remember I got the box from Australia. And I opened it and I was like, I just put them in the warehouse.
Did you ever try them?
Yeah, I have them on my 450. I love them.
You still run them?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I still love them.
They're awesome.
I was worried that if I had them like on my personal bike that I race and stuff, mm-hmm. I would have a hard time with test bikes and doing shootouts and stuff, but it wasn't. It's not like I'm, oh, they're not there.
Yeah,
it's
just, for sure.
When they're there, it's nice.
It's nice, yeah. You almost forget about them, and that's why I like them. It's like they're not doing anything negative. Yeah. They're just there if, like, I don't even know how to explain it. I mean, you know what I mean, but
yeah,
they're sweet.
So everything's different for you, pretty much. Bell helmet, Fox gear, mm-hmm. Scott goggles.
Yeah.
Getting on with everything okay?
Yeah. I mean, it's great to be back with Fox. I was with them for... oh boy, almost 5 years, I want to say. Mm-hmm. And then went to like Rock River and all that stuff with Moose and all that. But yeah, I was with them for a long time. So being back in that stuff's awesome. I was in the Bell with Star before they went to Alpine Star. Mm-hmm. So no, all those guys, helmet's great. Scots are new for me, but they're sweet. Yeah. I mean, mm-hmm. I'm not picky with like, I don't know. I grew up running just whatever. So, yeah. Like,
so you're not saying, oh, I need 32 pants with a 30 waist. And
no, well, that's the thing with Fox that's sick is, like, everything's custom.
Oh,
like,
really?
Fits. So, like, it all fits amazing. Yeah.
Nice. Okay, elaborate a little bit more on your own deal thing. Like, you're in Florida. You're going to be training with VL, Sexton, and Roxon.
Yeah. There's obviously some other people at Sandbox. Also, the HBI, Cowie team. Not sure if Shane is still there, McElrath. But yeah, pretty much me, Tom, Chase, and then Ken's always been there. Yeah, we're out there at Sandbox. As far as off the bike, Peter Park is helping me out now. So,
is that new for this year?
Oh yeah,
obviously
yeah.
At Swanee.
Yep.
So you're going to get buff.
Yeah.
Put the muscles on.
Oh yeah, yeah. But yeah, that's pretty much the program.
Nice. One more quick break to hear from our sponsors. Back for one more second. Welcome back to the SML Show presented by OGIO Powersports and Yamaha Motors. So we're talking about training with Peter Park and training your body a little bit differently. Earlier you alluded to the most frustrating moto win of your life at SMX, but like it's kind of been like that, right? You're just like one week you're like, where's Levi? And the next week you're just whooping everybody's ass. Is it lack of conditioning or lack of something else, consistency? I mean, what has led you to these up and down results you've had, and what are you looking to do to change it?
It wasn't conditioning, no. I mean, I think you can always be better, but it was just lack of confidence, like mentally. Mm-hmm. My head gets in the way a lot, and like I think who knows that best is my old trainer, Rob, who will be back around with me again, which is nice. yeah, I can just get in the way of myself for sure. So that was kind of, you know, like a big thing with switching it up and kind of doing stuff on my own, is like, I'm not around people all the time that I'm racing, and I can kind of work, like, I can do more, or I can do less, or I can do whatever I need to do to feel 100%. And I think that's going to be really big for me. And just when I line up, knowing that, you know, I'm going to do my best to work harder than everybody. So having that confidence will be huge for me. Mm-hmm.
It seems like when you get a good start, it's like, see ya.
Yeah.
Like, is it like when you get a good start, is there just like this open the floodgates full of confidence, like piecing out on these guys? Or is it when you get a bad start, you're just like, oh,
now no, it's like, that's where the confidence thing, like I need to realize like whether I start in 10th or 5th or whatever the case is, like I need to be at the front. And like, that's where when I hole shot, it's pretty like, it's not super hard to, like, I know I can, it's almost like I can always go whatever pace I need to, if that makes sense. Mm-hmm. And when I start in the back, like, I just don't have like that, or I didn't really ever have like that confidence, like I can move through these guys. So yeah, that's a big thing I need to work on. And yeah, I would say just knowing that I need to get to the front at all times. I mean, I would work my way up a little bit, but never enough.
Have you ever worked with like a sports psychologist or
no,
something like that?
I really haven't. I probably should, but yeah, maybe. I don't know. I don't want to go, like, I don't want to, I don't know. I don't even know what I'm going to do, but if it doesn't help, then yeah, I probably would look into doing anything. I mean, I'll do anything it takes to win.
Who's the hardest guy to pass when you come through the pack? Is there one that stands out?
Jalik Swole is hard to pass sometimes. My new teammate Volan can be hard to pass. I don't know, but I might be hard to pass. I mean, I don't care if people say that about me, but there's just people that are good at knowing where you're at on the track. I mean, mm-hmm. I don't know. I think everybody's hard to pass. Honestly, everybody's so damn fast now.
Yeah. How do you get on with your new teammates? Have you spent a lot of time with them yet?
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, I'm a like pretty friendly person, so I feel like nobody really, I mean, maybe people have problems with me, but I don't care if they do. But for the most part, you know, I knew Cameron a little bit. I knew Max a little bit. You know, you pretty much eventually run into all those guys, and I know Seth a little bit. I don't really know Austin at all, but yeah, everybody's cool.
Yeah. So how about the new number, dude?
Yeah, I earned a career number, which was sick. And I actually, well, first I messaged Brayton because I wanted 10. He said no, he's going to keep racing, so that got shut down. And then I was thinking about 20, but yeah, I talked to my parents a little bit, and they're like, you'd be dumb not to do 47. I mean, that was my number all growing up. And then actually when Shimoda came over here, he was 47. So I added a 1 because I kept having to slash my number at every race.
Yeah.
So Joe, if you're listening, thank you for that. And yeah, so now I picked 47 and I'm stoked on it.
Yeah. Going back to your like amateur number that you've always had, you've got some identity with that and everything, but how much marketing is there in that? Like, you know, people always say, oh, I'm tied to this number and everything. Like, are you gonna do 47 merch? Or,
oh yeah. Yeah, probably, because that was another thing. 22 is available. Mm-hmm. Everybody's like, oh, that'd be sick. But I'm like, there's a lot of the numbers are branded already, you know, but that was one, obviously it's huge with Chad. So I feel like 47, I know Emma Granite, One Punch Evans.
One Punch.
Yeah. But it's not super branded. So I feel like it'd be a good number for me to brand myself around. And then obviously if I earn a single digit, I would go to a single digit. But yeah, that's the plan with it.
Nice. Where did the nickname Chef come from? Was that like a TV announcer thing, or has that been a lifelong?
No, I don't even. It was somebody. I don't know. Somebody at Loretta's, I think, that I feel bad not knowing, but I don't really know how it came about.
Are you fond of the nickname, or are you just like?
Yeah, I think it's sweet. I mean, it's. I never realized how good it is actually for like branding and merch and all that kind of stuff. It fits well. So yeah, I don't mind it. I think it's good.
Nice. Okay, so 2024, the last round of Super Motocross next year. What's gonna make you happy? Like, what are you hoping to accomplish this year? You think you can win a title with the new team first swing out?
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, I'm not gonna be happy unless I do win a championship. Yeah, that's pretty much all there is to it. I mean, I would like to win them all, right? Mm-hmm. But I'd definitely be bummed if I don't win one. I mean, it's big expectation, but that's what we all expect. So I think it's perfectly normal.
Yeah. Well, there's three titles to win now, right?
Exactly. In like a order though, I think an outdoor title is gnarly. I think like that would be my number one, Supercross, and then Super Motocross would be at the bottom of it.
Yeah.
Because it's three races.
Yeah. Pays a lot though.
Does pay a lot, but I don't know. I think an outdoor title is like the peak.
Yeah. Okay, so we're out of time, but we're kind of talking about money. Like, how old are you right now, Levi?
22.
You made 100-something grand with Super Motocross. I'm sure you made good salary, good bonuses from the wins that you had. What do you blow your money on? Or are you a super smart guy saving everything?
I mean, I wouldn't say I'm like super smart with my money, but I'm definitely like...
But you got a house.
Yeah. But small things still like are cool to me. Like I could go buy a nice bass boat, but I'm probably going to spend around $12,000 and just get like a Bass Tracker, which is not a very like super nice boat. So yeah, fishing stuff. I don't really blow my money on much. I mean, I want to save up and get a car at some point, something cool, but I don't know. I've had a lot of speeding tickets, so I don't really think that'd be a good idea. But yeah.
Right on. Well, hey, thanks for coming on again. I think this was your third or fourth show, but we always enjoy working with you, and best of luck in 24.
Thank you, guys.
All right, guys, thanks for checking out the SML Show. Please like and subscribe, and we'll see you next week.